All right, here we go. I'm coming back. Cool. That Stardew Valley conversation going on. I do want to play a video game, like do a video game stream at some point. Because I want to do a stream where we kind of sit down and play a game and study the. Not like super hardcore academic study, but like study the like what it's doing narratively. Sort of look at it from a storytelling perspective and how it does things differently and how it does things the same. Kind of, I mean, in a certain sense, this conversation we're having right now is an example of that, of wanting to do something similar. I had to wear it at least once, Johnny. It's like, I won't say it's my signature, but you know, it's kind of part of my stream. It's too bad the Jays lost, though. I haven't played Stardew Valley in a while. I'm not gonna lie. I'm totally Team Leah. Gotta love the Cubs. No, man, I actually am so rooting for the Cleveland Indians to win. My friends may hate me for saying so, but like they look so solid and I'd like to see them do it. Well, I agree that their name is super racist. I would never not say that. Do I think they're the biggest underdog? I don't. I really don't. Can you call the team who won the most games by far in the league this season the underdog? I don't think you can. But hey, what do I know? That doesn't make them an underdog. But it's like the curse of the Bambino, right? Like eventually they're gonna win it. The other reason I picked Cleveland is also because if they won the World Series as well, it would be like riots in Cleveland, because of both basketball and baseball. Like, it'd be ridiculous. Yeah, I know. I'm aware. I wouldn't be sad if they won. Like, I'm not saying that. I don't want them to lose. I'm just saying I like the Cleveland Indians. I would prefer if they won, but you know. Is what it is. How would you even tell? That's very true. You probably wouldn't be able to tell. I'd like to know the statistic on that though. When was the last time a Oh, it was probably Boston, I suppose. Depends how you count it. But when was the last time one city won multiple, like a multi-sport championship? But it was probably Boston, because if I'm not mistaken, that was the year Boston won the Boston Bruins won the cup, the year that Boston won the World Series. But I could be wrong. Well, it's a well-known fact that Sam doesn't like sports. Yeah, Boston Bruins. Hockey teams, man, hockey teams. Ah. Yeah, was that not the year? Got it. I need to know now. No, I'm wrong. They were in different years. Yeah, I'd like to know the statistic on when was the last time, or yeah, when was the last time a city won multiple, like won multi-sport championships. Yeah, I just give you a hard time, Sam, because I know you played rugby and all that, so like it's not like you're LA 1943, 2009 Pittsburgh. Was that the Pirates? Or was that a different Wasn't the Pirates. Steelers and Penguins. Gotcha. That makes sense. Ooh. Well, that was during the years of the original six, though, right? But interesting. Does Detroit have a football team anymore? Am I crazy? Oh, they do. I forgot about them. Lol. Yeah, no, that's fine. I looked it up. I just forgot. They're not a very notable team in recent years, so fair enough. I don't follow football very much. I'm not a football guy. Yeah. It's very true. Well, I'm well aware of hockey, and I'm well aware of baseball. So I remember those two. That's not a problem. And basketball is, Pistons? Oh no. God, this is terrible. It is. Yeah, it is Pistons. Okay, I'm not crazy. Yeah. Stardew Valley already. Do I even have Stardew Valley installed? I mean, probably. I don't like this line. Yeah, that's I was thinking it. Well, with Westworld under new ownership, who knows? Just for the record, guys, no spoilers. HBO is owned by Time Warner. So, assuming this merger goes through, they are now owned by AT&T. No, it won't. It would be very unlikely, but just because I was mentioning it earlier. How would I describe this thought, Sam? I'm not entirely sure. I also left the door open. Yeah, I think that merger really depends on who gets elected. Well, some of Disney's direct competitors are in Time Warner. For example, DC Comics. I don't blame you, Droney. Don't blame you at all. Yeah, I hear you, bud. I hear you. Me too. I need to work on my comic skills as well. I'm trying to channel my inner Sam here. Right, yeah, my inner Sam. You haven't heard me mention it. I mean, I don't consider prose to be my strongest point as a writer by far. Whereas Sam is significantly better at it than me. Pros for sure. That little pros muscle that I don't use as much as I should. I don't understand your question. Oh, yeah. Those pros things with descriptions and stuff. I consider myself to be a very lean writer as far as that stuff goes. You are correct. There are very few pictures there. Don't you start now. Hmm. If you want, Bode, you may make such a comment. I give you my permission. You guys are funny. Yeah, that's funny. How dare I? Ouch. Ouch, that's hurtful. Very, very hurtful. We're doing okay. Trying to get some more imagery in there. These are funny. I'm trying, Sam. Do I ever write funny things? That's a good question. I would say the answer is no. Some people would say the answer is yes. Do you ever write good things? Ouch. All the burns today. There's a scene better than the insurance payout? Man. So I'm not sure I believe you that there's a better scene than that, because it was that sounded pretty fantastic. All right. Hit me up, man. Hit me up. That's the third one in the three body problem, right? Like, that's what we're talking about? I need to read those. I really do. I think I would love them. Oh, right, that crazy guy that you like, yeah. Okay, I'm following. Okay. I'm following so far. Okay. Oh my God. Okay. I'm intrigued by this story. Oh man. That's amazing. Yeah, this writer sounds awesome. Scalzi. Well, the insurance thing is awesome. Was an awesome one, and Redshirt sounds really good. So, he sounds pretty cool. Oh, okay, it was the three problem, blah, blah, blah. Three body problem. Yeah. I got there. I follow now. It took me a bit. Had to come around. How many articles do you write a week, Boat? Like 10? Is that like the final total, or is that just what you're working on right now? Okay. So are you just working for one company then, or are you working for multiple companies? You don't have to answer, by the way. if you don't want to, I understand how. Okay, gotcha. Yeah, I was thinking about getting into some more freelancing stuff. Nice. Sounds pretty decent. $60 an hour is nothing to sniff at. Yeah, I hear Yeah, I agree with you, Sam. Sorry, John, I did not mean to ignore your question. There was just other questions in the middle. It's hard to determine what makes a good story. In my opinion, mostly because it really depends on the person. There's no, like, this is the greatest story ever written or anything really close, you know? Yeah, and to a certain extent, I like stories that, I like two different types of stories, and this is kind of what I was talking about a few weeks ago, but I like stories that make you feel, like they give you shivers when something happens, and I also like stories that make you think, that push your mind creatively. It's hard to find both in the same story. It's not very common. Mostly because they're trying to accomplish different tasks. But it is possible. The one thing I will say is, I think we can all kind of agree that the really good stories, the really good writers, are the stories that you can read, that you have to read multiple times in order to fully understand everything. That is to say that every time you read it, you experience something new. Because no one likes a story that gets, like, we've all seen those movies that we liked the first time we saw them, and then we watch them again, and they're not nearly as fun because we have all the information. But the really good stuff is the stuff that doesn't get old in that way, where you continually see new things and understand a little bit more about it every time you read it. Like for me, that would be like Brent Weeks, the Night Angel trilogy. I've read all three novels probably 4 or 5 times now, and I've read the graphic novel and I've listened to the audiobook, because the audiobook's my graphic audio and it's really good, and I get a different experience from all of them. That's not to say that the story is inconsistent or anything, or that the adaptations are bad. It's just you get a different sense when you see it visually, and you get a different sense when you hear it, and you get a different sense when you read it. And all of them go towards making this whole of the way that the universe interacts with itself. Yeah, right, Sam? Like, there's kind of this... Yeah, I mean, I agree with you to a certain extent, but, like, I think of, like, for example, watching Pulp Fiction for the second or third time, and how different that is from watching it the first time. Where there's new things, there's different things, it's a different experience. But Tarantino is very dense in that way, where he, you know, he has references to things where there's nothing arbitrary. But see, Sherlock for me isn't about surprise in a smart way. I like Sherlock because I identify with the character. Like, I understand that madness on a certain level. That push for understanding. Yeah. It is a blurry line. That is true. Yeah. It's hard to say. It's hard to say. It's all a matter of interpretation, right? Like, we're not gonna like the same things, and for that reason, we're gonna think different things are good. I guess my favorite example. My favorite example is reading Hemingway in school, and how much everyone in my class hated it. But I really liked it. I liked reading Hemingway. And I have since read several of his novels and liked it. Like, there's things we consider different for different reasons. All right. It's time for break number two. I'll be back and I'll continue writing till about 3 o'clock, and then I gotta go watch that hockey game, as it were. Not making as much progress as the beginning section, but we're having an interesting intellectual discussion about writing, and I think that's important. So yeah, break time.